In my last video, I got a peculiar comment by Kobe Bryant. He says, "Try complicating English words as much as possible."
What the f*** does that mean, Kobe Bryant?
You're welcome.
What the f*** is he talking about?
Well, they are not Kobe Bryant and I'm not Kanye West, so let's figure this out. I don't know. Let's start with the dictionary, I guess. Oh no! It appears the inside of this dictionary was replaced with an history book. Let's read it. In late 2020, I took a Japanese class at my university. That's where I learned about Hiragana. Hiragana is one of the alphabets used in Japanese, and that's about the only thing I remember from the class. But one thing I do remember, from outside the class, is a small project that I made after being inspired by that alphabet. See, Hiragana is an alphabet where each character is either a vowel or a combination of a consonant plus a vowel. Of course, not the actual letters, but most of their sounds. Essentially, Hiragana is an alphabet that consists of syllables like hi, wa, ga, na. There you go. That's a very simplified explanation of Hiragana, but it's really interesting though and you should look it up. But let's go back to that project I mentioned. After finding out about this alphabet that was basically made up of sounds, my brain started working slightly and it made me realize something. With an alphabet like Hiragana, it's like you were writing with sound. So maybe you could take something written in Latin and turn that into sounds. You see where I'm going with this? With a little magic, that's how I made a very mid text-to-speech program. This is the part where I'm gonna throw you all a bit of a curveball. Bars. See, I made this project in Turkish. The reason is, I simply don't know Japanese that well, and English has some really complicated pronunciations. But in Turkish though, basically every syllable is pronounced the way they're written, just like in Hiragana. But how do we do this? The concept is simple, as the title hopefully suggests. We take a sentence and speak it.
Okay, genius, but like, what do you mean?
Thanks for thinking I'm smart.
You're welcome.
We start by reading the sentence that will be spoken. The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. A sentence which I should have included in the fonts video. Not sure why I didn't. So let's break this down. Hey, I'm gonna keep this part. Okay, stay with me here. We're gonna look at a Turkish phrase, so don't be scared. That means lazy dog in Turkish. It's pronounced tembel köpek. If we break it down, we can see that the syllables are made up of a consonant, a vowel, and sometimes a second consonant. We will be ignoring that second consonant though. The reason will shock you, but not yet. The consonants that are not followed by a vowel are considered as a single letter and not a syllable. Same goes for vowels that are not preceded by a consonant. Even though technically they are syllables, just in this context they are not. So we can use this pattern to detect what the syllables and individual letters are, by reading each character one by one. We start from the left. If the first character is a vowel, because it's not attached to a consonant, it's considered a single letter. We move to the next character. If it's a consonant, it could potentially be a syllable, so we check the next character as well. If that one is also a consonant, then this is another single letter, so we move to the next character. But if it's a consonant that is followed by a vowel, we have a syllable. We move two characters instead. This process is applied to the whole sentence. So this basically gives us a list of sounds, either single letters or syllables. Of course, spaces and commas are considered pauses. Now, we should be able to play this list, sound by sound. Speaking of lists though, my friend is about to release the first chapter of his game soon. It's an RPG where you can change your eye color for different attacks, and there's actually a pretty cool story. But there's a lot more to it than that. If that sounds interesting to you, you should add it to your wish list, hence the list connection. You can find the Steam link in the comments. But now, we need the sounds. For the list. This part probably sounds, pun intended, cooler than it actually is, but we basically need a vocal alphabet. A small soundbite of all possible sounds here. That means A to Z as single letters, and all consonant plus vowel combinations. The Turkish alphabet has 29 letters, 8 of which are vowels. So we need a total of 29 plus 21 times 8 sounds. That's around 197 things I needed to record. So I did! I remember staying up that night in my dorm room just recording these, not knowing how they would turn out really. It was a weird night, but who would have known that I would be making a video about it almost 4 years later. Oh, and remember how I said we would ignore the second consonant in the syllables? Yeah, well, if we did include them, I would need 3,528 recordings, plus tax. So there we have it, one of the weirdest things I worked on almost 4 years ago. Oh, you wanna hear what it sounds like? You probably don't want to hear it unless it's your first time watching this video, in which case, curiosity will get the best of you. So you know how it feels weird when you listen to a recording of your own voice? Imagine that, but you put extra emphasis on every possible sound that your mouth makes. But here it is. So you can see this is the program right here. It's really just a bunch of empty space, but basically, This is a console window that I created, and you can write your sentences in here. So on the right, you can see all like the vowels I have here. They're all recorded. Vowels, none else. The double letters are the Turkish letters, which don't actually show up, or you can't really use it in code like this. So that's why they're those. Anyway, okay. So tembel köpek, right? So this is going to say tembel köpek, but the way it's going to read it is it's going to split it into a list, like I mentioned, and it's going to be tembel space köpek, and it's going to sound bad, but you're still going to be able to hear tembel köpek. So let's see it.
Tembel köpek.
God. Okay. Yeah. That's that's it's what it is, but it basically speaks in Turkish, right? So if we can say merhaba,
merhaba,
it kind of works, right? But if you want to say English words, English things, you don't really write it like, so let's say lazy dog. If you write it like lazy dog, it's going to say
lazy dog.
I mean, dog was kind of right, but it doesn't really work that well, right? So to make it say lazy dog, we say lazy and dog.
Lazy dog.
Kind of works. So maybe we want to say created with Game Maker Studio 2, because I didn't, I guess, name the project name or the application name. So for that, we can say created with Game Maker Studio 2.
Created with Game Maker Studio 2.
I mean, yeah, it is what it is. Don't go too harsh on the poor thing. It's doing its best. English words.
English words.
I don't know if I can get more complicated than that. At some point, I will probably record new sounds for this and fix their timings. But besides that, you can probably see how this is me trying to complicate English words as much as possible, right? I mean, create a text-to-speech program for a different language, then make it say English words by writing their pronunciation. That's a lot of steps for something really simple. But thanks for watching, Hangvio. Assuming you're the only one to watch this video, which I hope that's not the case. That'd be sad. Anyhow, I'm gonna let Text to Talk play you out.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Me love you long time.
Consonant. Continent. Constant, consistent, contest.